Okay. Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. It means so much to me that you all are here. And thank you so much for choosing this event tonight on such a holy day. It's my pleasure to present this music for you tonight. Tonight, you'll hear a variety of music spanning the centuries, from the 17th century, which you just heard, all the way up to the present day. Most of the music tonight is extremely fitting for the season of Lent, 40 days to remember Christ's death, leading to his resurrection on Easter. This next set will feature music that, for me, evokes a Lenten spirit. British composer and suffragette Ethel Smyth, her prelude on the Lenten hymn tune, O Darkest Woe, O Heart's Pain, is part of a set of five preludes written in homage to Johann Sebastian Bach. I'll continue with Nadia Boulanger's improvisation in E-flat minor, not something I normally play. It's not specifically for Lent, but I feel like the melody she wrote is so fitting. Christopher Tambling's toccata on Aus der Tiefe, or how we know it as 40 Days and 40 Nights, is a rousing and bombastic depiction of the hymn's text. This next set will end with a setting of Were You There by Emma Lou Deemer, a prolific American composer and performer.
Thank you.
thank you. So, like most of you here tonight, there are so many people in my life that have been supportive of me and my life with this instrument, the organ. But none have been quite so unique as my grandfather, David Booth Beers. About 3 months ago, I had my very last meaningful conversation with him on the phone, and he asked the usual questions. How are you? What are you doing right now, or having for dinner, or what are you doing this weekend, and what are you playing? I often had long conversations with him about music, but more recently we talked about hymns. He knew them all. He knew all the words and all the very many different tunes. He might groan at my first choice, okay? Amazing Grace, I don't think that was a favorite. But Diane Bish's setting of this tune is one I think he might have liked. It starts out how you'd expect, and then it takes a turn. Last week at his memorial service and celebration of his life, I had the pleasure of playing The Emerald Isle by Charles Callahan as part of the prelude. Technically, though, this is an organ duet. So, I've modified it just a little bit to play it as a solo. Apparently, my grandfather was friends with this composer, and he always enjoyed his music. And this piece is an arrangement of Londonderry Air, or Danny Boy. And we are Irish, so it was very fitting. I will finish with an arrangement of a hymn my grandfather mentioned back in January during this same conversation. When he got sick, I ended up recording this hymn for both him and my grandmother so they could sing along with it. And as I was overlaying the text on the video, thanks to COVID, I know that skill, I was struck with how powerful the text of this hymn, "In the Cross of Christ I Glory," was. I'll read it for you now, or some of it. "In the cross of Christ I glory, towering o'er the wrecks of time, all the light of sacred story gathers round its head sublime. When the woes of life overtake me, hopes deceive and fears annoy, never shall the cross forsake me. Lo, it glows with peace and joy. When the sun of bliss is beaming, light and love upon my way, from the cross the radiance streaming adds more luster to the day. Bane and blessing, pain and pleasure, by the cross are sanctified. Peace is there that knows no measure, joys that through all time abide. In the cross of Christ I glory, towering o'er the wrecks of time, all the light of sacred story gathers round its head sublime." So again, thank you for coming, and please enjoy the next three pieces.